Okay, now I will demo the TV volume guard, or TV loudness guard. I haven't really decided which name to pick. And here you will see the sound sensor basically sits and listens to the TV volume. And soon as the TV volume reaches a certain threshold that was set in the Arduino program, it will send volume down remote control signals to the TV, and the TV basically will lower its volume, and so long as the volume is below a certain threshold, the TV loudness guard will continue to send the volume down remote control codes to the TV. Okay, you will also see a blinking LED, green LED light, soon as the sound sensor kicks in, meaning that as soon as the sound sensor detects the volume above a certain threshold, the green LED indicator will start blinking. That means it's also sending the remote control code. So let's give it a shot.
You can hear the cheers from the crowd of the long shot players. Let's go, Donna.
See, you can see the volume bar. I'm going to increase the volume, and the gadget is taken over.
Those prices momentarily. Meanwhile, back at the ranch known as Laurel, race number 5 is 2 minutes away. Bubbling Springs, as mentioned earlier, scratched out. We've got a field.
Can increase the volume. See, it's fighting me actually. It's punishing me.
My top horse because of the scratching of the 7. They were 5-1 when we first looked at this race, now down to 5-2. And while they may not have the best numbers, what the 2 has is consistency and the potential to pull off a gate to wire.
Just got a B+ next to Punta Sal, by the way, online.
Oh, I put
so
that
he
one
likes
on
the 2.
Since the purpose of my Arduino TV loudness guard or volume guard is to basically sense a certain volume loudness, and if that loudness level is reached, Arduino will send through the IR transmitter a remote control code to either turn the TV off or bring the volume down. In my case, I want to turn the volume down when the sound coming out of the TV basically exceeds a certain level. So this utility that comes with the IR remote library allows you to decipher or decode remote control button keys. So this way, if I don't want to go and search in the manufacturer's manual as to the code being sent by the remote control when I press the volume down button, I can just use this utility through my Arduino and an IR receiver, and it will automatically show me the code behind this button. So I'm going to open up the serial monitor. I'm going to point my remote control towards the IR receiver. I'm going to press volume up. There you have it. It thinks that my remote control is an NEC. It's actually, it seems to be using an NEC protocol, even though it's a Sanyo remote control. So let me press volume up again. Okay, so this is the hash code for the remote control button volume up, and this is the raw data, which I believe is the frequency characteristics, the delays, and the pauses, etc., etc. So if I press the volume down, this is the code for the volume down. And if I press the mute button again, just to be sure. Okay, so the one that I'm interested in is actually the volume down, which is this one. So here it tells me that this is the code coming out of my remote control when I press the volume down button, and it's a 32-bit data value. I will need this to be able to plug it into the functions that are available with IR remote. Okay, now that I've captured the code sent by my remote control for the volume down button, all I have to do is basically paste it here. I've already done that. This is the code that I've captured using the receive remote utility dump. And what's going to happen in my program is that Arduino will basically listen to the sound sensor And when the noise or the volume coming out of the sound sensor exceeds a certain level, which I set here, and you can decide, basically you have from 0 to 1023 depending on the distance between the sound sensor and the TV, depending on your comfort level and depending on other variables. You have to play around with this until you get the value that you want. And here, of course, I can decide how many times I want to send this code quickly, one after another in a loop. So this is my code. Here I'm testing for the sound level, and if the noise exceeds the noise level I've set, which was 350, I'm going to turn the LED on, the green LED on in my case, wait for 200 milliseconds, and then send the remote code. In my case, it's the volume down code. Send it five times with a small delay in between. I can reduce this from 5 to 3 if I think that the Arduino is dropping the volume just too fast, too low. And when I'm done with the loop, I basically turn the green LED off.